Hello, everybody. I am Keaton, and this is Kid Catholic, Season 13, Episode 1. I hope that you all are having an absolutely wonderful Tuesday so far. I know that I am. It feels good to say that again. I haven't been here in like a solid 3.5-4 weeks because I have been in Italy for the last 3 weeks, and I don't even know where to start with this video. First of all, I want to say that at the end of this video, I'll be showing kind of like a recap video that I put together to sort of give you an idea of some of the stuff we did on the trip, but also some of the fun moments from the trip. And so please stay tuned for that. If you follow Kid Catholic on Instagram, then you've already seen that. But regardless, it is a really fun video, so please stay tuned for that at the end. Secondly, again, big announcement coming up. I've had some of you reach out to me. It's not like I'm quitting and going away. That's not what the announcement is, but it is really exciting for the future of this channel, for the future of this ministry. So please keep an eye out for that. Now, when I did the Uganda recap, I felt like that was a little bit easier simply because knowing what all we did, it was a little bit easier to keep track of. This, we were up and going for 20 days, 3 weeks of just nonstop action. So I literally have the schedule pulled up in front of me so that I remember what we did. So this is what it was. It was Journey with Dante through Benedictine College, it was a study abroad program for 3 weeks. And we got to go study Dante while in Italy, go to a lot of the places that he went, and then also experience so many cool stuff. It was me and 21 other students that got to go together, and it was an absolute blast. We spent the first 2 days in Atchison on Benedictine campus before finally leaving for Italy, and our first stop was Rome. This wasn't like we just spent the time in one city. We went to a whole bunch of different cities. We went to, I'm going to try to see if I can do this by memory without looking at the schedule. Rome, Vatican City, Assisi, Florence, I'm already blanking, Ravenna, Verona, Venice, Milan, Padua. I think that's it. Maybe I'm missing one. I don't know, but we'll see. So yes, we arrived in Rome, and we got to go to St. Mary Major, which was really, really cool to get to see. I have been to Rome already, and I have been to Assisi already, and Monte Cassino and Subiaco. So some of these places that we went, I had been to already, but then by the time we got to Florence, and from that point on, I hadn't been to it. But it didn't make the Rome portion, just because I'd been there, any less enjoyable. I still enjoyed every single moment of it, getting to go with these absolutely incredible people on this trip to Rome and see all these different things. Now, one of the things that we did was go to Santa Croce in Jerusalem. And for those of you who have been following me for maybe a long time, maybe you remember, maybe you don't, the significant story that Santa Croce in Jerusalem has for me. My confirmation saint is Saint Croce, meaning the Holy Cross, because of that church. Santa Croce in Jerusalem is a church in Rome. And at first, I didn't know if we were going to go to it, so I took some of the other kids on the trip up there, and we got to see that. It was just like a 20-minute walk from our hotel, but then we ended up going back to it again, which was amazing. But there's a relics case, and I'll pull up a picture of it here, that has the INRI sign above the cross. It has, I'm not gonna be able to remember everything, the finger of doubting Thomas. It has a nail that pierced Jesus. It has thorns from the crown of thorns. It has fragments from the pillar that Jesus was scourged on. It has one of the beams from one of the side thieves that was next to Jesus. It has another part of the cross. It's just absolutely incredible. So many amazing relics up there that really had a spiritual impact for me. And so getting to go back there and bring people there who hadn't been there before, it was absolutely incredible. We got to go to St. Peter's Basilica and visit the Sistine Chapel, which was absolutely awesome. Here are some pictures from St. Peter's Basilica that we got outside of it. We got to go to Mass there again later on. We went back there and went to Mass there, which was incredible. So this was like the 22nd we got to Rome. 23rd was where we got to go see St. Peter's Basilica. Again, I'm literally like looking at this schedule because it just helps me. Now, on the 24th, we went to St. Paul Outside the Wall, which is an absolutely incredible church. It's one of the four major basilicas. It really, really is beautiful, and it has portraits of every single pope to ever be in the Catholic Church on there, which is really, really cool. Then we got to go visit the Colosseum and the Forum. What's really cool is that we were in a really special place when Roe v. Wade was overturned. We were at the Forum. exploring the forum when we all like check our phones and we realize, oh my goodness, Roe v. Wade just got overturned. What was really cool about that was getting to celebrate it with other young people who were, are also pro-life, are also against the murder of abortion, or the murder that is abortion. And so getting excited that Roe v. Wade got overturned, it was just really an incredible thing to get to experience that in a place like the Forum, when exploring around ancient Rome, along with other young people also getting excited about it. It was just really, really a gift to get to experience that at the Forum. Now, I can't take time explaining everything or else this would be an hour-long video, but Saturday we went to the catacombs, which was really, really cool, and we got to visit St. John Lateran, which is, again, one of the four major basilicas in Rome. It's kind of down the street from Santa Croce in Jerusalem. Then we got to go to Mass in St. Peter's. Oh my goodness, absolutely beautiful. Beautiful Mass in St. Peter's, and then we got to be at the Angelus with the Pope, so got to have stuff blessed by the Pope, which is really, really cool. Then on Monday on the 27th, which was my birthday, I celebrated my birthday away from my family, away from my twin for the first time. But these people still did a really, really good job of making me feel at home despite that. So got to celebrate my birthday abroad in Italy. Here's a video from that. They explicitly went out of their way to like get me a joke apron, a gladiator helmet, like stuff like this is like as birthday presents, and then physically do that night. It was really, really special to get to experience my birthday with these incredible people. But the day trip was to Subiaco and Monte Cassino, which was really, really cool. And then on the 28th, this was Tuesday, that was when we left Rome. So we had spent almost a full week in Rome, and we went to Assisi. Now, absolutely love Assisi. Absolutely incredible city. Taking our bags up to Assisi, up to the hotel, maybe the worst experience of the trip. It was physically draining. Maybe I'm over dramatic, maybe I'm just a wimp, but to me, oh my goodness, it was very draining. Anyway, so I tried to get like vlog style stuff as much as possible within this trip. I didn't want to just vlog the whole thing because I wanted to be able to experience it. Why didn't I get a vlog style video while in Rome? Phenomenal question. I just didn't, which looking back on it, I'm really mad at myself for, but I did in Assisi. So here is me with some of my friends up there in Assisi. So now I'm here with my buddy Tommy.
Hi.
He's my roommate for this trip. Tommy, what has been your favorite part of Italy so far?
St. Paul outside the wall.
St. Really Paul cool. Outside the wall? Yeah. That was sick. So now we're here with more of my buddies. Tommy's still up there. And Nina and Fiona. So we'll start with Nina. Nina, what has been your favorite part of the trip so far?
I don't know. I guess... I liked the Vatican. There's this one stained glass window that's stunning. It lights up the whole room like it's golden hour, and that's pretty cool.
Awesome. Fiona?
Definitely the St. Cecilia. There was like a St. Cecilia... Stop! There was a St. Cecilia altar, and one of the churches we went to, I forget the name of it, but it had like... I was able to like light it up, and then it had all the stories of St. Cecilia and like her life and Tommy. Yeah. So that was my favorite part.
Awesome. And then here are some more of my buddies on the trip.
Bye.
Yes. Okay, so again, we're gonna go back to the desk, but I'm gonna try to get some more videos like this as we go to the different cities, because I think that it's important that you guys get some of my thoughts while I'm here rather than just when I get back, because I'm really enjoying my time here. We're having a blast. So thank you guys and enjoy the video. Getting to stay the night in Assisi was really, really cool. And then we spent the next day, a little bit of it in Assisi as well before moving on to Florence. Now from that point, Florence and beyond, I hadn't been to. So Florence was a really, really cool city. We got to go to the Duomo, the bell tower. They have like a huge tower, and me and some of my friends, we climbed all the way to the top, got these beautiful views. Check it out. It was just absolutely incredible to get to see Florence from the side. This was a highlight of the trip for me. Don't get me wrong. I mean, it was exhausting getting up there, but honestly, for how high we were, it wasn't that bad. And it was great to get to have that surreal view, from that high up. Absolutely just beautiful view. from the bell tower. Then that was the 30th. So again, I'm trying to move my way quickly through the trip. I'm having to bring up like the next section of the schedule here in order to fully remember what happened. So next, the day after that, after we went to like Dante's house and saw a lot of stuff Dante related in Florence, because he lived in Dante, or he lived in Florence, grew up in Florence. After that, we went to castles, and the castles were honestly pretty cool. I wasn't really looking forward to it. I was like, what is this about? But it was really, really cool. We had class every day. Some days it was on the bus, some days it was in the hotel lobby, but this day was probably like the prettiest class that we had. It was right, like sitting at tables, right with like a old church right there and beautiful hills around us.
So this is a couple days later from the last clip that you saw when we were in Italy. We're now in Florence. We got here yesterday, just went a little bit away from the big city, up to a castle that Dante stayed at. So have you enjoyed Florence so far, Tommy?
Yeah, honestly, Florence has been really pretty. Yesterday we were in the main like center of town, a lot of shopping districts.
A lot of them.
Yeah. A lot of leather stuff. I bought a leather jacket. It looks really cool.
You were a great negotiator with the leather jacket too.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
You're welcome.
But yeah, so Florence has been really cool. There's definitely a more wooded area, but it's a little bit cooler than it was in the city, so that's been nice.
Yes, yesterday we got to climb to the top of like one of the towers in the central city, right next to a church. It was absolutely beautiful, got a view of the whole city. But yeah, we're enjoying Florence so far, and again, I'm trying to give you guys as much of our thoughts while we're here as possible.
The next day, we continued in Florence. We went to Santa Maria Novella, which was a really, really cool church that we got to go to. We got to see so many beautiful churches that a lot of them kind of run together, which is somewhat unfortunate, but that was just, you know, part of it. Next in Florence, the next day, that was Sunday the 3rd, we had Mass. The Mass was in English, which was really cool to get to experience an English Mass abroad. I don't know. I thought that was cool. And then we had the scavenger hunt. The scavenger hunt was something that was somewhat hyped up for this class. It was a part of our grade. My team got last place, but you know, we gave our best effort. We still got what we needed, and we tried really, really hard, and we bonded as teammates. So that's what that was about. We did get last place, but it's okay, because the scavenger hunt was for like different plaques throughout Florence, from the Paradiso or Purgatorio or Inferno, Dante's Divine Comedy, different excerpts from it hanging, like plaques essentially throughout Florence. And we got it, you know, we found enough. We really, really tried. Now, after this, we spent like 4 days in Florence. This was kind of, we called it our Italy road trip. This was essentially when we started a new city every day, going through Italy, bang, 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 because at this point we had been to Rome, Vatican City, Assisi, and Florence. So next was Ravenna. Ravenna was really, really cool. We got to see some awesome Byzantine churches. We got to see Dante's tomb. Here is a picture of Dante's tomb. It was really, really cool to see that. We didn't spend a night in Ravenna. Ravenna was just a day trip, but Ravenna is known for mosaics. Saw some absolutely beautiful mosaics. And then we took a train. We took a bus. We did take a train later on, but at this point it was the bus to Padua. And Padua, we stayed several nights in, despite there being a fire alarm when arriving at the hotel, and then suddenly stormy weather was outside as if it wasn't before. So it somewhat felt like the apocalypse was happening for a solid 2 minutes, but it was great. It allowed us to bond more, in Padua. So then we visited St. Anthony's Basilica. Like, oh my goodness, guys, I don't even know where to start with St. Anthony's Basilica. St. Anthony's Basilica exceeded my expectations in every way. Maybe my third favorite church of the world. Church of the I've ever been to, at least. Church of the Holy Sepulchre, Santa Croce in Jerusalem, and then Basilica of St. Anthony. St. Peter's has got to be up there for me. I just have like a personal connection with these churches. St. Anthony's Basilica was so, so beautiful. Getting to walk in there, and to the left, there's the tomb of St. Anthony. Here's a picture of that. You keep going down, there's like a relic room. We got to see the incorrupt tongue of St. Anthony. So many like amazing things in St. Anthony, and being able to experience it with other young people who were also astounded, who were also devout in their faith, and just in awe of what they were seeing. It was absolutely amazing. That church especially, I really got to experience it with someone else. It was just really, really cool to see another young person be so like into the faith and be as spiritually impacted by St. Anthony's as I was. It was really, really just, I could go on and on and on about that church. Here are some pictures from the outside. Beautiful church in Padua. So we went to the Scriveni Chapel that night. That was a cool experience. Here are some pictures from that as well. The next day, so we spent that next night in Padua. The next day, this was Wednesday the 6th, we went to Venice.
Hello, everybody. I've tried to do as many cities as possible. I couldn't get a video while in Padua. We're staying three nights there, but we were only like in Padua for a day, so it was really difficult to get videos from there, but I'm doing the best I can. So here I am in Venice, and the cool thing about Venice is that a lot of times when you go somewhere, there's sort of the picture in your head.
Hi.
Here are two of my buddies on the trip. Basically, what I was explaining is, and I don't know if you guys would agree with me,
yes,
about Venice, what's unique is the picture that we have in our head of a lot of places is oftentimes inaccurate, but in Venice, for the most part, I feel like it's spot on.
Yes, S tier.
So we got to go on a gondola ride, and we got to experience Venice. You're getting to see a little bit of it behind me. We are headed back to the train to head back to Padua now. But yeah, I'll show you guys some pictures from Venice. What have you thought of Venice so far, Fiona?
It's honestly been my favorite place we've been to. I think
absolute favorite.
We set the bar really low.
Right.
We've just seen pictures of it, and we're like, oh, it's gonna be what it looks like online. But it's like it's what it looks like online, but like 10 times better.
100%, Nina.
Okay, it was insane. I was like, okay, you can photo edit water, right, to look as blue as it does in pictures. No, it just like looks that way.
100%.
And then you come in, and it's just like this sunny, beautiful, like beachy, like pink and bleached, beautiful town with gondolas everywhere, and like fantastic. I was like, oh wow, like this is right out of the tour book. You should draw it.
It has been absolutely amazing. So. We'll go back to the desk, and then I'll show you guys some more pictures from this. But we're headed home in 3 days. It's been a great experience so far.
It was beautiful. Like, it's hard to describe how awesome Venice was. We got to ride a gondola. Here are some pictures from that, getting to explore Venice. Oh my goodness. It was absolutely amazing. We got to go to where they make glass. Here are some videos of them making glass. And just overall walk around in Venice, spend the whole day in Venice. So Venice, again, we didn't spend a night there, but it was a long day trip. Like, I think it was our longest day trip we had. We were there, we woke up bright and early to go to Venice, and we didn't leave until like 10:30 at night. So we were there essentially the whole day. And it was really, really cool. We took the train back to Padua and then stayed overnight in Padua again. Next was Verona. Here is another like vlog style video from Verona.
So now we're here in Verona. Verona is just a day trip, so we left from Padua this morning, and then now we're headed to Milan, and we'll be there for the last two nights. What have you thought about Verona?
I thought it was really cool. I just read Romeo and Juliet for school, so coming and seeing the place where like the Montagues lived was really cool and a fun experience.
Awesome. I didn't even know that was here until we got here, and then also getting to see a lot of where Dante lived. It has been amazing so far. So I'll see you guys in Milan.
Verona, it was just absolutely beautiful. Honestly, Verona exceeded my expectations as well. I don't think it was fair it being back to back with Venice, because like none of the cities were going to top Venice. But Verona, beautiful city, town of Romeo and Juliet. Dante stayed there when he was exiled a lot. The current Alighieri family, descendants of Dante, live there. Again, home of Romeo and Juliet. I didn't even know that until we were there, because yeah, they're fictional characters, but the families that they're from, that's real, and the play takes place in Verona. So it was really, really cool to get to go to Verona. Beautiful city, beautiful place. And then we transferred to Milan, and Milan was our final destination on this trip. This was on the 7th. We left Milan, and we stayed the night in Milan. We stayed two nights in Milan. So Friday the 8th, we got to go to the roof of the like Duomo, the big church in Milan. Actually, fun fact, the largest church in Italy is in Milan, because St. Peter's Basilica is technically not in Italy. It's in the Vatican. So because of that technicality, the largest church in Italy is in Milan. So it was really, really cool to see. We got to have, obviously, lunch there. We got to have a lot of free time, a lot of shopping time there. We got to go to St. Ambrose Church there in Milan. We got to see the tomb of St. Ambrose, which was really, really cool. We got to see the tomb of St. Charles Borromeo. We got to see the baptismal font in which St. Ambrose baptized St. Augustine. Here is a picture of that. Absolutely incredible experience. And me and some of my friends, we had this like really nice moment on the last day of just us sitting in the park, a park behind one of the castles in Milan. I'm assuming there's multiple. That's the only one we went to. But behind a castle in Milan, and just got to, there was a musician there, and we just all sat around knowing that it was our last day, a full day in Italy, and just experiencing it together. The next day, bright and early in the morning, flew from Milan to the United States of America and said goodbye because, again, the people on the strip, they're all plucked from different states, essentially, so we all live really spread apart. But if I were to describe how genuinely amazing this trip was, I couldn't even do it in words. It was very spiritually impactful, being able to connect with so many other young people who are just as devout in their faith was absolutely incredible. It's the longest that I've been away from home, that I've been out of the country, 3 weeks. Like Uganda, when I made that video, that was 2 weeks, and that felt like a long time. I didn't think it was to the point where it was too long. It was just like by the end of week three, it's like, okay, like now we're ready to go home. So it was a lot of fun. Again, it was truly an amazing experience, and I would highly suggest Journey with Dante. It's for rising high school juniors, rising high school seniors, and rising college freshmen. So I am going to be a senior. So I was like kind of in the middle of the grade levels. So it was really, really cool to get to go and experience that. Again, I'll add in as many pictures as possible, as many videos as possible throughout this post later editing. Keaton will, he'll worry about all that work, which is going to be me in a couple hours. So it was just, again, like it's hard to describe, but I would 10 out of 10 recommend Journey with Dante through Benedictine College to anybody. Best way to get summer college credit, absolutely, is by going to Italy, making all these new friends. And again, the people on this trip are just indescribable. Like I mentioned, I made like an edit of some of the fun moments we had in this trip. So here is that video.
Cheers!
Remember when we all got drunk? I ended up with two broke thumbs. Oh my god, I felt so dumb. Lucky me. I wrote a song that no one knows. I played a show and no one showed. Oh my god, I felt so alone. Lucky me. When all is going wrong and you're scared as hell, what you gonna do? Who you gonna tell? Maybe a
100 bad days made 100 good stories. 100 good stories make me interesting at parties.
100 bad days made 100 good stories. 100 good stories make me interesting at parties. Yeah, no, I ain't scared of you. No, I ain't scared of you no more. No, I ain't scared of you. No, I. Tell.
maybe I
100 bad days made 100 good stories. 100 good stories make me interesting at parties.
100 bad days made 100 good stories. 100 good stories make me interesting at parties. Yeah, no, I ain't scared of you. No, I ain't scared of you no more.
So thank you all so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Because this is sort of a special video and it's running on the longer side, we are not going to have a saint of the week, but the saint of the week will be back for future videos. It's not like we're just dropping it. Please click the red subscribe button down below and the bell next to it. That way you get notified when I come out with a new video. I'm not just a YouTuber, I'm also a Catholic speaker. So if you want to book me to come and speak at your church, school, parish, men's group, women's group, youth group, conference, you name it, I would absolutely love to. So please email me directly at kidcatholic1@gmail.com or go to my website, kidcatholic.com, click the contact me page, and email me directly from there. That would be absolutely lovely. Please check out all three of my social medias, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. The link to all three of those will be in the description down below. Please visit my website in general, kidcatholic.com. So many awesome things that you can do on there. Please comment any saint or topic suggestions that you might have for future videos. I would absolutely love to hear it. And again, guys, please stay ready for the big announcement coming here in just a couple weeks. It will be absolutely amazing. This was Keaton of Good Catholic. I hope that you guys are really enjoying your summer so far, having a great summer as we get closer to the start of the school year. And I will see you all next week. Hi, Brielle.